We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win, and the others do.
We do see that.
Okay. That's looking out in front of the orbiter.
Okay, we're seeing three or four objects. Can you confirm that it's just the one that's actually moving? The other ones are just reflections?
No, there are three objects. The one you see two rings right there. They're the ones we kind of had the late tally-ho on. The one down the bottom, that was the one we initially saw.
We have an unidentified flying object.
Just pass off the nose again. Right now it's at about 12:30 and it's passing out in front of the vehicle.
We're Tally-ho. Can you get a still imagery if you can and any estimate on size or range?
Looks like you got an object right in front of you, Mark. Can you look out there? That's what you're talking about. Never mind. Are we missing something? I don't see anything.
An object which is at the same place all the time but appears to be tumbling. Well, we've had it ever since yesterday. It just seems to be tagging along with us.
There we go. Well, let's see. We've had visitors again.
Yeah.
Currently worth mentioning.
Agreed.
Do you believe in life on other planets?
Oh, yes, there's not much question at all. But there's life throughout the universe. We're not alone in the universe at all.
You're convinced that we're not alone in the universe?
Oh, I know for sure we're not alone in the universe. And I happen to be privileged enough to have been on the fact that we have been visited on this planet. And the UFO phenomenon is real, although it's been covered up by our governments for quite a long time. It is a real phenomenon. And there's quite a few of us. It's been well covered up by all of our governments for the last 60 years or so. But slowly it leaks out. And some of us are privileged to have been briefed on some of it. But I've also been in military circles and intelligence circles that knows beneath the surface of what has been public knowledge that, yes, we have been visited. I have been deeply involved in certain committees and certain research programs with very credible scientists and very intelligence people that do know the real inside story, and I am not hesitant to talk about it. There's quite a bit of contact going on. We have been visited. The Roswell crash was real, and a number of other contacts have been real and ongoing. It's pretty well known for that in the last 60 years or so that there has been some back engineering and the creation of this type of likely alien craft. Now, not all of them are. I suspect some of them are homegrown. I suspect that in the last 60 years or so that there has been some back engineering and the creation of this type of equipment, but it's not nearly as sophisticated as yet as what the apparent visitors have.
They're not going away from me more than maybe 3 or 4 miles per hour. They're going at the same speed I am, approximately.
Houston with Atlantis Commander Brent Jett talking with astronaut Terry Wirtz here in Mission Control about an object the crew members noted outside the windows of the Space Shuttle Atlantis.
Terry, we're in the process of taking pictures with the 400. We've got several other pictures as well, but the best view we got was through the binoculars, and the best way I can describe it is there's some kind of reflective cloth or with some metallic looking type of cloth, a structure that's definitely not rigid or it's not a solid metal structure.
We see a long line, a couple of star-like things, and a lot of things swimming in the foreground. Can you describe what you're seeing?
Well, the long line is a tether, and there's a little bit of debris that kind of flies with us, and it's illuminated by the sun at such low angle. So there's a lot of stray light, and it's getting washed out quickly, but Claude is trying to do a quick, good job here adjusting the cameras.
Copy that.